Good morning, and welcome to St. Mary's, even in these dog days of summer, as we celebrate the 19th Sunday of Ordinary Time. We begin in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. My sisters and brothers, in today's gospel, when Peter begins to sing, Jesus catches him and asks, O you of little faith, why did you doubt? For the times when our own faith has faltered, let us ask for pardon and healing.
I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
A reading from the Book of Kings. At the mountain of God, Horeb, Elijah came to a cave where he took shelter. Then the Lord said to him, Go outside and stand on the mountain before the Lord, the Lord will be passing by. A strong and heavy wind was rending the mountains and crushing rocks before the Lord. But the Lord was not in the wind. After the wind, there was an earthquake. But the Lord was not in the earthquake. After the earthquake, there was a fire, but the Lord was not in the fire. After the fire, there was a tiny whispering sound. When he heard this, Elijah hid his face in his cloak and went and stood at the entrance of the cave. The word of the Lord. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, I speak the truth in Christ. I do not lie. My conscience joins with the Holy Spirit in bearing me witness that I have great sorrow and constant anguish in my heart. For I could wish that I myself were accused, accursed, and cut off from Christ for the sake of my own people, my kindred according to the flesh. They are Israelites. Theirs the adoption, the glory, the covenants, the giving of the law, the worship, and the promises. Theirs the patriarchs, and from them, according to the flesh, is the Christ. who is over all, God blessed forever. Amen. The word of the Lord. Get into a boat and precede him to the other side, while he dismissed the crowds. After doing so, he went up on the mountain by himself to pray. When it was evening, he was there alone. Meanwhile, the boat, already a few miles offshore, was being tossed about by the waves, for the wind was against it. During the fourth watch of the night, he came toward them walking on the sea. When the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were terrified. "It is a ghost," they said. And they cried out in fear. At once, Jesus spoke to them, "Take courage, it is I. Do not be afraid." Peter said to him in reply, "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." He said, "Come." Peter got out of the boat and began to walk on the water toward Jesus. But when he saw how strong the wind was, he became frightened. And beginning to sink, he cried out, "Lord, save me." Immediately Jesus stretched out his hand and caught Peter and said to him, "O you of little faith, why did you doubt?" After they got into the boat, the wind died down. Those who went in the boat did him homage, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." The Gospel of the Lord. Today's story, the retelling of Jesus walking on the water, has many interpretations to it. We hear of the wind and the sea. We hear of Peter and his followers, the other disciples. We hear of a voice. We hear of a hand. All of these are somehow tied together. But one common thread through all that is that the story deals with an unearthly event. Jesus, a man walking on the sea, and his apostles, understandably finding it frightening, they cry out that it is a ghost that they are seeing. In the church's wisdom, it is appropriate this gospel is paired with the account of Elijah's journey to a cave on Mount Horeb, fleeing for his life from the anger of Queen Jezebel. It's evident that we don't hear everything that has preceded Elijah's fleeing, but we do hear about his immediate encounter with God. Elijah was looking for peace and quiet, for a place of safety, but instead, God calls him out of his somewhat hiding place. Elijah is told, go outside and stand on the mountain before the Lord, for the Lord will be passing by. You can bet Elijah couldn't muster enough courage to leave that cave, let alone be prepared to see God. He hears the heavy winds, feels the earth shake, and sees fire, but does not encounter the Lord. Then from outside this place of safety, he hears this whispering sound. No words are spoken. He hides his face in his cloak. And it reminds me of Linus in the Peanut strip character, in the comic strip, with his blanket. And he goes, puts his face in the blanket, somewhat like Elijah did at the entrance to the cave. And there he listens to God's gentle presence. It is here where God reveals to Elijah his new vocation as a powerful prophet. There is more to be done in God's name. Our readings today suggest that there is more work for all of us to be done. As God's people within our faith community, we are called to be present in the presence of Christ in our day-to-day lives. And we hear Pope Francis say time and time again that he's made it very clear that Christianity is much more than a system of beliefs. It is a very deliberate way of life. It is a life requiring the use of every spiritual resource that is available. Matthew's gospel develops a similar theme. Last week we hear of Jesus feeding the crowd. Today he sends his disciples and everyone else away and goes off to pray. But while in their boat, the disciples find themselves in mortal danger. They are caught in this violent storm, and they think that they are seeing a ghost coming toward them. They then hear his voice, the same voice that had told them to share all that they had with the hungry crowd. This same voice calling out to them, take courage, it is I, do not be afraid. And from this, Peter takes his cue to come and begins his walk of faith. Peter takes this leap of faith, bringing all his flaws along with him as he lands on the water. Yet Peter's doubt in his surroundings gets the upper hand. He begins to sink. Jesus immediately reaches out to Peter with a human hand, a hand sensitive to touch, to hot and cold. This human hand that could bleed and drive a nail. A hand that could be raised in prayer and blessing. A human hand that could hold and be held. Jesus reached out to Peter with a hand like yours and mine. Hands that wash dishes, change diapers, press computer keys, and do all sorts of things. It is a hand that paints pictures and drives cars, wraps packages and operates machinery, one that even plants during this time of year. Jesus reached out to Peter with a human hand, a hand that was also divine. These were hands that touched blind eyes and gave sight, touching lepers and making them clean. He touched crippled bodies, making them whole, turning death into life. Peter's faith should be an inspiration for each of us. These same hands reach out to us. With today's current health crisis, and societal concerns. We've been put in situations that we've never dreamed of finding ourselves in. Maybe we feel like we're sinking in oceans of despair. We're going under. We feel the winds of hopelessness, our faith turning into fear. It's times like these that we must listen for the voice of the Lord who says, have courage, it is I, do not be afraid. These readings today remind us that God speaks to us and calls us in many unexpected ways. in the whisper of our hearts, or even in the more obvious and stormy ways of our everyday lives. In this Eucharist, we share as one. We experience Christ's call and power in a uniquely profound way. We come together to this altar, renewed in faith, with a sense of trust and confidence in Him who can and will help us stay on top of the water.
We stand as a people who cry out, Jesus, save us, as we proclaim our faith in the Nicene Creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, God not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Jesus tells his disciples, do not be afraid. With perfect trust that banishes all fear, let us bring our needs before the Lord.
For the church, that we may recognize God's presence in both the extraordinary and ordinary events of our lives, so that we may cooperate with God more fully. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For greater civility in public discourses, that all political leaders may show respect for their opponents, express their ideas and concerns thoughtfully, and to work to promote the common good of society. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Mateo Guerrero, who, as he receives his first Holy Communion at Mass this weekend, that he and all our children continue to seek the bread of life throughout their lives. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our St. Mary Parish, may we come to find God in the still, quiet moments of our days and bring his peace to all we meet. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are ill, that God will relieve their suffering, bring healing to the sick, and sustain them as they work to recover their strength. Especially Chris King, Madeline DeRue, Vicky Kirksey, William Von Haney, Susanna Zubek, Irene Vega, and Thomas Brinkman. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, may they be gathered into God's loving arms, especially Louis Gomez Jr. and Gail Schaub, sister of John Benson. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parishioners for whom this Mass is being offered, and for the prayers we voice in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Also, in a special way, we pray for all those who died and those affected with injuries and those who have lost loved ones in the explosion in Lebanon. May they be given peace and healing and comfort. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of wind and sea, calm our fears and bring us peace. Hear the prayers of your Spirit. Inspires us to offer and grant what we ask through Christ our Lord. Amen.
You shall cross the barren desert.
Himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from You're indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For in the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. So we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. To confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Blaise our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you gain for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you in your compassion, O merciful Father. Gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom, that we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Gracious you grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And offer now to one another a sign of peace.
now pray the act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you in my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. May the communion in your sacrament we have consumed save us, O Lord, and confirm us in the light of your truth, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Also, just as a little update for where we're at with our parking lot, we actually have started the bid processing this week. The Archdiocese had sent out to different vendors, preferred vendors and those that they have worked with before, for our parking lot, for the project to be completed this fall. So it'll be about a 3-week process for as we receive bids, then we'll receive those, and then with our building and grounds committee, we will decide which one is the best for us based on cost and timing. Because we're shooting for going into process in late September or early October, depending on the availability of whatever contractor we work with. So please keep all in your prayers that we could get good, healthy bids, also low bids, if that those are the best ones, and that we may all continue to walk this journey together. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you. Father and the Son and the